convinced that to fully capitalize on tourism opportunities, it's important to get the big picture. So they've commissioned 13 artists from around the country to portray Welland, past and present, on a series of downtown murals. Going to the wall for tourism, the painters are following a pattern set by Chemainus, British Columbia, a small town that has achieved an economic resurrection by adorning itself with 24 murals in the past 6 years.
Actually, plant your feet right into the painting itself, and it's a nice feeling as an artist to be able to step right into your own work.
And festival officials are hoping to step right into a new economic era, one in which Welland will be the picture of prosperity.
This is artist Brian Romanelli, and this is about the biggest thing he's ever painted. It's a piece of the history of Welland, Ontario, and it's an attempt, in part, to give the city a new image of itself, and also, in part, to make a buck out of the tourist industry.
It's a 50-foot-high symbol of how, in the early 1800s, they dug canals through town to bypass Niagara and open up the Great Lakes. Now the big ships bypass Welland, and the city's getting over a few lean years. So these mammoth murals, 13 of them, are designed to boost civic pride and attract tourists from nearby Niagara.
All you need is a couple hundred liters of paint, some spare brick wall space, and a lot of imagination. These pictures were taken in Welland, Ontario this summer and fall. 13 huge murals were painted by 11 Canadian artists, which depict the history of the area. It's all part of a five-year plan to bring in tourist dollars to Welland's declining economy.
The heart of the Niagara Peninsula decided to spruce up its downtown core. The result is a program called Festival of Arts 88. As Bill Brammer reports, the ambitious project has turned Welland into a spectacular canvas.
Hotel, and people can not only watch history being made, but also recorded. The results are spectacular and give a new meaning to the phrase painting the town. Bill Brammer, Global News in Welland.
Certainly, Mr. Mayor and representatives from Welland, you need to be commended, not only what is physically happening, but what is happening in the spirit in that community. And have a good season.
Good afternoon. I'm Tracy Levy from Niagara College, and today we're going to be talking a bit about Welland's Festival of Arts with our guest, Rick Woodward. Good afternoon.
Thank you. Hi, Tracy. Thanks.
Could you tell us a little bit about Welland's Festival of Arts?
Well, the Festival of Arts is a creation of huge outdoor murals in our downtown area. 14 were created last summer by artists from across Canada. They came from as far away as Alberta and British Columbia. They work right outside on the scaffolding, creating murals, some of them over 1,300 square feet. And the idea is to turn our community literally into an outdoor art gallery.
All the very best of luck to you.
You too. Thanks a lot, John.
Thanks, Bob. Great mural artist. Get down to Welland and have a look. It'll be really worthwhile. Now let's go back to Barrie.
A few more years before Welland gains a solid reputation as a popular tourist destination. But if this second phase of the arts festival is any indication, the city is certainly on the right track. In Welland, Lauren Saffron, Newsroom 11.
Utilisé à des fins publicitaires, il est allé à Welland. On utilise les murs là aussi pour des fins artistiques et par ricochet touristiques.
Welland. Pour les Ontariens, ce nom est synonyme du fameux canal. Mais tout ça risque de changer. Cette municipalité veut se donner des airs de ville artistique.
The city of Welland was about to lose a landmark, a giant mural on the side of a building that is being torn down. The ingenious solution was to move the whole wall to a new location down the street. Construction crews have been working all week to cut the wall away from the foundation and welding a steel frame around the wall to support it. 34 murals now, 10 of them created this year alone. Festival of Arts organizers hope to install so many more murals in the next 3 years that Welland will be known as the world's largest outdoor art gallery.
Lots of people have done a paint-by-number project sometime in their lives, but in Canada, they are doing it on a very big scale. Take a gander at what Welland, Ontario thinks is the world's biggest paint-by-number mural. unveiled this afternoon in the heart of that city. Countless people, including our own Tom Joles, worked on the project, which may be headed for the Guinness Book of World Records. People paid to fill in those spaces with money going to help the Cancer Society.
Gentlemen, we do have a thank you to say, especially to John Van Cooten and Rick Woodward. Rick is executive director, and you are chairman, sir. Thank you very much, both of you. I hope you will find a mutually agreed upon place to hang this plaque. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.
Rick, just before the show, about these murals. John, I haven't had a chance to talk to you, but what I was impressed with is the scope, the ambitious nature of this project. Is this something that you hope will make a significant difference to life in Welland?
It certainly will. This will be the start of an economic miracle for our community, and in 5 years, we hope to have 1 million tourists a year here. That's going to put Welland on the map of the whole world.
Rick, you've been involved with this from the beginning. Do you share that optimism?
Greg, I think we already are seeing people coming to the community who have heard about it, even from the Niagara Peninsula, wanting to see the actual artists at work. Once the program is even finished in year one, obviously people will be able to see them forever, but to actually see the artwork going on the walls now is exciting.
Yeah, you and I were talking earlier that this isn't just an event which you hope to use up the summer months with. This is actually about a five-year plan, maybe.
That's right. Indeed, 13 this year, and again, hopefully within 5 years, we could have 30 or 40 murals and other works of art here in the community.
We will watch as Welland assumes more color and art. Thank you both very much, gentlemen. Rick, you're the handiest there. I'll ask you to press the button.
Well, from Chemainus, British Columbia, and Rick Woodward joins us from Welland, Ontario. Judging by how the weather looks, I'd rather be in Chemainus. Carl, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Yes, we have beautiful weather here.
Rick, how about you?
I'm very well, thanks, Peter, but a little chilly here in Welland today.
I think that mural behind you, Rick, I think you better do something about that train and the car. It looks like it's going to be a horrible accident.
Well, the mural depicts the immigrant families that came to the community to help construct the Welland Canal many years ago. You see the picture of the three boys, a little boy and the youngsters arrive with his mom and dad, and the youngster grows up to be a dad and takes a wife and has a daughter, and then you see the same boy depicted as a grandfather telling his grandchild what it was like coming to the community so many years ago.
Yeah, but you got to get the car off the tracks there. Carl, the mural behind you is the first one ever painted. That really got everything going, didn't it?
That's correct. That was the first mural depicting a school donkey at work in the forest industry. And that happened in 1982, the very first one, the most important one to us and to many other communities.
Are you surprised, Carl, by how popular it's become?
Not really. The popularity of the murals here in Chemainus, we kind of foresaw that, at least I did, and I think the mayor did as well. But the fact that we now export the idea to other communities, that's overwhelming, really. I didn't expect that at all.
You got the idea from traveling in Europe, right?
Yes, we got the idea when the wife and I traveled in Romania, and we saw some of the monasteries. They had their religious history painted on their walls, and the nuns wisely charged entrance fees to the monasteries, and I thought that was a great idea to come to Chemainus and get the attention of the world to our history.
What kind of help do you give somebody like Rick in Welland, for example? What kind of advice were you able to help him out with as he started his work?
Well, Rick and their committee, we shared all our experience, and we try to tell them not to make the same mistakes as we did. And a lot of them, believe me, and we are still learning. And this is a sharing project between this community and our projects. And I think learning from each other and sharing our experience is what will be beneficial to both of us, as well as, of course, sharing the project with the visitors to come from Chemainus and then visit Welland and all the other projects, and vice versa.
marketing, that is the benefits of what you call putting the teams together.
Rick, tell me how you organize the whole thing. How many artists, how much paint, how do you get organized?
Well, it was a monster project, and again, Carl is very accurate when you say that he was cooperative and helpful in getting our project off the ground this year. We did 13 murals this year, which was a major undertaking, to say the least. We had artists literally from across Canada submit maquettes of models who wanted to come to the community and be a muralist. The mural that I'm standing in front of was actually done by an artist from Chemainus, Dan Sawatsky, who Carl knows very well, and Dan has done a couple of murals in that community.
Yeah.
The project was a $300,000 project, and all of the money was donated. We're a non-profit organization whose mandate basically is to improve the economic base in our community through the development of a tourist industry.
Is it too early to see whether or not it's had an impact yet?
No, it's not. I can't give you specific figures, but you can certainly see the activity that's been created in the community during the summer and fall. Actually, when the artists were working on the walls, they would tell you the numbers of people that dropped by from out of town who had heard about the project and wanted to talk to some of the artists while they were working. So we've seen a reality of the project already.
Carl, what kind of mistakes has Rick been able to avoid based on your experience? I would think that you'd have to use a special kind of paint and experiment with the paint, do you?
Well, the paint is, I think Rick is using a different paint than we do. We use acrylics and let the wall breathe. And I think Rick is using a different paint. However, we want to learn from him.
Rick, what kind of paint are you using in Welland?
Well, we used a paint called acrophane, Peter, which is the same type of paint that's used on jet aircraft. It's actually a catalyst, two different components mixed together. And when the paint hardens, it's almost like a rubber compound.
So the weather's okay, right?
Well, that was the key, obviously. We didn't paint our murals right onto the building blocks or brick. We put a special covering onto the walls called the therm wall. And then the artists used this acrophane paint.
Carl, you've been as far away as Australia, I understand, selling this idea. Where are you going to go next? Have you had any other invitations?
Well, we're looking to Europe and Japan, definitely. And once all those places have their murals and a number of them, like Welland, for instance, then we'd like to set up a program where we visit each murals around the world. And I think that's a great experience for art lovers.
A great idea. Then you can come and work on my hallway, all right?
Okay.
Thanks a lot, Carl.
It's been my pleasure indeed.
All the best. Thank you, Rick.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Rick.
Very much, Peter.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
The most expensive art collections may be found in Paris or Rome, but the largest certainly belongs to Welland. The Niagara community owes its heritage to the man-made canal that gives passage to ships between the Great Lakes. But lately, the real attention is being paid to a sizable investment in art. They are aptly named the Giant Murals of Welland. Some of the 28 works reach 3 stories in height and span the length of half a football field. Using buildings as their canvas, selected Canadian artists dip their brushes deep into the city's colorful past and paint it in broad strokes. The self-guided tour through this outdoor gallery can be as educational as it is engaging, and it's hard to refute that even when art is bigger than life, it can still imitate it, especially when it stares you right in the face.
Sunday AM.
In its glory days, the city of Welland was a thriving metropolis with a booming steel industry and steady canal traffic. Then the recession of the early 80s hit, and the city has spent almost a decade trying to get back on its feet. A new artistic initiative seems to be brightening the city's future. Sunday AM Steve Simic was in Welland to investigate.
Lift bridges that haven't been in operation for years. Smokestacks that stand as statues of an industrial era gone by. Like many cities across Canada, Welland fell hard in the economic recession of the early 80s. A glut in steel prices and decreased traffic on the seaway resulted in a downturn in the city's economy. But the city is undergoing a transformation as it shifts its economic focus.
it's visually easy to see that there an effect is happening just by walking or driving our city streets and seeing the people out there with cameras.
Main streets, the attraction isn't obvious. A look to the left or right explained the excitement. Reflections of the city's past and present painted on buildings large enough for all to see. Tell me about the olden days, depicting the arrival of immigrants in 1910. Upbound at midnight, a night scene featuring the ship Arendelle proceeding along the Welland Canal to Port Colborne. It's known as the Festival of Art and was initiated last year. So far, 24 of these murals line the streets and several more are planned over the next 3 years. Artists from Toronto, Montreal, Vancouver, and Welland's own come to add their distinct style to the city's street front.
Well, you can work on an easel painting for a long time and nobody ever sees it and nobody ever gives any feedback. There's a public response to something of this size that's sort of overwhelming. People can't help noticing it just because it's so big.
While it's too early to see if the murals have had an impact on tourism in the city, the executive director of the Festival of Art is confident the historic scenes won't go unnoticed.
We're 20 minutes from the falls where 15 million people a year visit and who are looking for other things to do while they're in the falls, other interesting things to see. We figured, man, this could really be a major project for our community.
As well as going for the tourism buck, the murals have helped to inspire renewed community spirit. Recently, an unveiling of the 24th mural was held in front of an enthusiastic audience. Involving over 800 artists and measuring 130 by 9.5 feet, this mural was painted by the citizens of Welland. The city hopes the Guinness World Book of Records will recognize the mural as the largest paint-by-number painting in the world, with the second record of the most number of people having painted the mural. Depicting the diverse ethnic background of Welland, the mural sees 10 flowers representing the countries from which the immigrants had arrived.
I did about a year and a half ago in watching the flame go across Canada to the Calgary Olympics. And in that way, we saw that if you could get that number of people to get involved with sports by carrying a flame, we could get the people of Welland involved by painting, you know, paint by numbers, so that you take a little bit of the mystique out of artwork.
It has developed a whole new sense of pride, I think, among Wellanders, and even the skeptics who earlier in the program thought paintings on walls, they really didn't understand the concept and that indeed it would attract people to the community. They're now the first ones, when they have visitors from out of town visiting their own homes, they're the first ones that I've got to take you out and show the murals.
With the backing of the city's residents, community leaders hope the artistic brush paints a clear message that Welland is once again open for business. For Sunday AM, I'm Steve Simic.
Great.